tell you what, $5 for number one, $10 for number two. Excuse me, what are you doing?
Playing a video game? So kids from our generation entertain themselves.
Charlie is watching her favorite show. It's the only way we can get her to sit on the potty.
Charlie has to watch the Gurgles in order to do her business?
Yes. The Gurgles help Charlie the same way that the sports section helps your dad.
Look at this garbage. Hardly colored singing and dancing shapes.
Would you guys just go upstairs? If she isn't potty trained by tomorrow, she won't get into the good preschool.
Come on!
Then we're gonna have to unhook the game system down here and rehook it up there. We already walked all the way down here. We're supposed to rewalk all the way up there?
No, we wouldn't have this problem if we had a TV in our room.
Okay, for the millionth time, I am not buying a TV for your room.
Fine. Let's go, PJ.
Oh, hold on. The circle and the square are fighting over a grape. I want to see how this turns out.
Been fumigated.
Oh. Well, I guess your parents didn't know that my company, Bob's Bugsby Guy, also does fumigations.
No, they knew that.
Oh, well, it's too bad they didn't call. I could have given them a big discount.
They knew that, too.
Oh. Okay. No biggie.
What was that about?
Who knows? It's your fault for saying, hey, Mr. Duncan.
Are you ready for the big news?
So always.
Here goes. There's a guy.
There's a guy.
There's a guy.
There's a guy.
Super happy dance.
Okay.
Super, super happy dance. Is he? He's that new guy in our government class, Raymond.
Oh, he's cute. Wait, so when did you start talking to him?
Well, we haven't actually talked yet. We've been IMing that led to texting. Tonight he wants to step it all the way up to video chat. I don't know if I'm ready.
All right, let's get you all queued up for your video chat.
If the bugs come back, I mean, when the bugs come back, this is my card. You know what? I'm going to get you a coupon. Wait right there.
Now's our chance. Go, 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 go!
All right, there we go. Brand new. Brand new. Look. Look at that. Now, when you're a big girl, this is where you're going to go potty. Now, just make sure the toilet seat is down so you don't fall in. Hopefully, you only make that mistake once.
Well, unless you're PJ, and then it's many, many times.
You know, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Sometimes I come up here, I don't even have to go. Sometimes Daddy just needs a little vacation.
Much nostril. Better, better. Now, let's see some shoulder. Oh, perfect. Now, flutter your eyes. Now, don't do that. Smile. Less teeth. More teeth. Less teeth. That's it, that's it, that's it. Now, don't move. Look right in the camera and tell Raymond what's on your mind.
I think I'm stuck.
You this after you exit the bathroom, but what was that horrible sound I heard a few minutes ago?
Charlie just threw some things in the toilet, clogged up the pipes. Sue, I just gotta dig a little hole in the backyard, clean out the main line. Don't worry, everything is gonna be fine.
Should I call a plumber?
Absolutely not. I have got this all under control.
Where's Charlie?
I'll be right back.
As long as you look scared, I've done my job. Boys, would you turn down that TV in your room? TV in your room? Oh, Mom, I don't think so. What is this?
A free TV.
Isn't it awesome? You can just sit on someone's lawn. Yeah,
there was a sign that said, please take. So we took.
It's a little big for the room, don't you think?
Yeah, it was at first, but then Gabe came up with the brilliant idea of bunk desks.
Bunk desks. Right. Where's your dresser? In your PJ's bed.
At first, you know, I was concerned that getting a fresh pair of underpants every day was going to be a little tricky.
Well, but then I came up with a solution. The underpants pillow. Every time I come in here, I regret it.
First of all, I'm fine. What? No! Didn't get electrocuted. Thanks for the concern.
What about the water?
All right. I've already called the plumber and the electrician.
Oh, there we go.
Who can't be here until tomorrow-ish.
Hey! We can survive one night without water and power. Come on, it's gonna be fine.
I heard some kind of explosion and rushed right over to see if Gabe was anywhere near the blast.
Right here, Mrs. Dummy. Better than ever.
You sure? No internal injuries?
My stomach is kind of upset. Maybe a touch of Dad Maria.
We're gonna be without water and power for a while. It sure would be helpful if we could use your bathroom till ours is up and running.
I don't even let Mr. Dabney use my bathroom.
An imposition, but the thing is, we have a really important preschool interview tomorrow morning, and it sure would be nice if we could use your bathroom to freshen up beforehand.
Need to freshen up, huh?
Yeah.
I hear the bus station has a real nice bathroom. Have a good night now.
Gabriel Duncan, Dabneria? Yeah, up to us.
When you said we wouldn't need this, who looks stupid now?
Which question should I answer first?
Any progress on the potty training?
Nope. Without the gurgles, Charlie won't even sit on that potty, and the interview is in 12 hours.
Oh, she'll get it. That's the thing about us Duncans. We're clutch players.
See the lights on. Not sure anybody's home. Where are the kids?
Charlie's taking a nap. Teddy and Ivy are downstairs, and the boys are in their room reading.
EJ and Gabe are reading?
Yeah, it was their idea.
So they're reading. Voluntarily.
Huh.
Let's roll. Oh, sorry. I warned you about that.
What is going on in here?
Great news. The power's back on. Well, it's for us.
Where are you getting your power from?
Hey, are you stealing electricity from Mrs. Dabney?
Are we in trouble? What's taking those nachos so long?
There really is a lot of stuff plugged in. Are you sure this is safe?
Here's a problem. We got a loose connection.
Everything's under control.
Huh. That's weird. This is Daddy's power's out, too.
Oh, look, here she comes.
You know, for an older gal, she moves pretty fast.
Nachos?
forever. Now I'm gonna die sad and alone.
Ivy, you're not gonna die alone. You can live with me and my husband. In our pool house.
No offense, but that sounds awful.
Not for me. I have a husband and a pool house.
You can just call Raymond.
Well, we can't do that. Our cell phones are dead and we can't charge them.
Use the wall phone. It works without electricity.
The wall what?
The wall phone? You know, the phone on the wall.
When did we get that?
When we bought the house.
Just one problem. Raymond's number is in my phone.
Oh, well, if you know his last name, just look him up in the phone book.
The phone what?
Okay, now you can see what it was like to live life in the olden days. Also known as the 90s.
Here's Raymond's number.
What?
Okay. Oh, it's right there.
Oh, mm-hmm. Right here. It's ringing.
Yeah, I'm sure you've heard all about me.
Oh, really?
Not a thing. Anyways, sorry we missed the video chat. There were some technical difficulties, so I don't know if you and Ivy are going to be able to talk tonight. Unless you want to come over.
Ivy loves the idea. I live at 358 Edgewood. Okay, bye. He's on his way over.
What are you doing, T? I told you I wasn't ready.
You like him, he likes you. Now get your booty in gear, girl, because it's time to represent.
Don't go straight on me, T. It's just sad.
Ready for Operation Potty Train?
It's go time.
We hope.
Okay, PJ. Let's hit it.
Okay, hey, Charlie, you want to watch some TV?
Yeah.
I bet your favorite show's on.
I bet, yeah.
It's time to giggle with the Gurgles.
Kids, today's going to be a super duper day.
Why is that?
Because we're going to do the potty rap. Hey there, kids, don't be naughty. Let's have fun and use the potty.
Didn't work.
Actually, it worked for me. See ya.
Hi.
I'm Raymond.
Hi, I'm Teddy. Come on in. Ivy, Raymond's here.
It's kind of dark in here.
Yeah, we're having a power outage. Could I offer you some chunky milk or a glass of ice cream?
I'm cool. Can I use the bathroom?
No. The water's out, too.
Oh. Nice place.
I'm going to see what's keeping Ivy. Just have a seat right there. Ivy!
Enjoying myself so far.
What's going on? What if I say something stupid? Then he won't like me. Ivy, you say stupid stuff to me all the time, and I still like you.
I'm serious, T. This is the first guy I've ever really liked. I don't want to mess it up.
Come on, you can do this.
I can't. I just know if I look into those big brown eyes, I'm going to freeze.
So you don't want to see his eyes. I can work with that. Have you movies right out. In the meanwhile, let's enjoy some nice battery-powered music. Kicking it old school, like they did back in the Dizzo.
Teddy, right. Ivy did mention you.
Okay, Ivy, come on out. There she is. Yeah, Raymond's right over there by the couch.
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Raymond, doesn't Ivy look nice?
I can't see her.
Take my word for it.
Okay. Ivy, you look good. Probably.
Thanks.
There you go. This is good. Okay,
Okay, come on, guys. We gotta keep it up. We're on a nice roll there. All right? Still just me talking. Still just... Guys, what's going on over there? Oh, okay. Don't need any light for that. I'll be in the kitchen.
I'm okay. I'm totally okay. Don't worry.
Okay, sweetheart. Why don't you go over there and play with some toys, okay? What does that smell?
That would be me. And somebody said we didn't have enough time to stop off at the bus station to freshen up.
Oh, so it's my fault.
My stink is your fault, yeah.
Okay, well, that makes a lot of sense. You know what? Tonight, when we're done here, I'm going to drop you off at the bus station. You can stay there and freshen up all night long.
All night long.
Sounds good to me. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm Sandra. Hi, I'm Amy. This is Bob. And this is Charlie. Something wrong with your face? No, there's some kind of odor. Oh, that's my husband.
Yeah, guilty as charged.
You know, we're having some plumbing issues at our house, and we weren't able to shower.
Yeah, that explains why I smell like a hobo.
Not that there's anything wrong with hobos.
No. Some of my best friends are hobos.
Yeah. Why don't we talk about Charlie?
It's a great idea.
So, how old is Charlie?
Already two.
Is she still napping? Most days in the afternoon, yes. Is she potty trained? Oh, of course.
Absolutely.
Yeah, potty train has left the station.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry about that. Charlie, sweetheart, can you turn the TV off? That's okay. Those little ones sure love those gurgles.
It's your favorite show.
Gurgle. So, the potty train hasn't left the station. Before you spend any time in preschool, you're going to need to spend a little more time in P-school. Sorry. It was either that or new school, poo school, and I decided to go classy. So.
Watch it, you idiot!
Speaking of classy, sounds like your brothers are home. One, two, three. What is that? Oh. 8-inch big screen. We found it in an alley. Yeah.
We're going to put it on top of the other one.
We're gonna make bunk TVs. They'll be out of the house by the time you're my age, and if not, then. Good luck, Charlie.
Duncan's Double Decker Warehouse.
House too small?
Family too big?
Then come on down to Duncan's Double Decker Furniture Warehouse.
For all of your stacked furniture needs. Wouldn't it be great if your couch could seat eight?
Got a full bladder? It doesn't matter.
Remember, that's Duncan's Double Decker Furniture Warehouse.
Stacking furniture since 2011. Charlie, not included.